don't ride with it.
I heard about that, yeah. Somebody told me that yesterday. Yeah.
Rook is back, but he's not paralyzed, right?
Hello, everyone.
He's gone, okay.
Welcome.
Go kart racing.
The Capital Investment Committee meeting for July the 11th, 2013 is called to order. I want to thank everyone for joining us this afternoon, those in the audience and those at home watching us. The first order of business is approval of the June 13, 2013 minutes.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, minutes passes. The second order of business is consideration of requested water availability for 1010 Malvern Road. Mr. Parker?
I'll defer to Mr. Hosen for explaining this one.
This is just for one SFUE. It's located outside the city limits and urban growth boundary, but it is within our water district, so we are recommending approval of one.
Just water?
Just water, and it's within our water utility district.
What size lot is it?
I don't know what size the lot is, but it's just for a three-quarter inch residential type meter is all it's for.
Motion to approve.
Do I have a second?
Second, but then I want to ask.
Okay, discussion?
Just for one?
One single-family residential house, the smallest meter you can get, three-quarter inch meter.
We have a motion and a proper second. All in favor of the motion?
Aye.
Okay, motion passes. Third item of business is consideration of change order number one, Cedar Franklin contract number 2012-0081 for the Maplewood Green Branch Stream Restoration Project with Viking Product Inc. for an increase of $10,333. This is funded under the Stormwater Capital Fund. Mr. Parker?
This is for a additional time, some additional time, and also is for additional bank stabilization after encountering conditions as the work was going on and removing of some deposition within the stream that was determined after the work started. So staff's recommending approval of it.
My comment is part of when we did this, just cleaning out the debris is normally not part of the expected work when we do this.
Well, obviously, or evidently, it is additional work that was not included or was not thought at the time that there was plans were put together, so, and Paul.
So it's an increase.
As we look at other streams, I think this is going to be important because, you know, for me, I would think this would have been a part of their restoration.
Well, it is, but you got to keep in mind, you put together a set of plans. You go out for bid, et cetera, for the set of plans, and you can have changes in that short period of time. And I don't know if this is what happened, but, and it could be that we added some length to it. I'm not sure.
And reality is, we planned on removing this type of debris during, through the stream and this deposition in the stream. It just overran the quantity essentially. So we're adding additional money to pay for the additional quantity that was not anticipated.
So we gave them a quantity when we put the bid out, and the reality is it ended up being larger. So we're just increasing the volume.
I can understand.
That sort of thing happens on a lot of contracts, unit price contracts.
If it happens a lot, why don't we just add it in to start with?
Well, you base a bid on a quantity where everybody is doing the same thing, and it is a calculated quantity on the front end, and it may come in different. When you actually do the work, you find out it's different. It happens on unit price items.
Wouldn't it be nice, though, if they said, well, you know, we didn't have nearly as much as we thought we were going to have, so it's a lot cheaper.
And that happens, too.
We do have decreases sometimes because of that.
That happens. On unit price items, that happens.
That's why we get the unit price, though. Putting the value in there helps them establish that pricing, and then we use that same pricing to apply to this additional amount. So we got a value in the bid process in terms of assigning the unit price that we could then apply to what really is needed. If it's more, like here, we had to add some to the contract. If it's less, we'd actually be able to decrease.
Is it usually the same?
We set those quantities, so in this case, we underestimated the amount that needed to be removed. They bid on that amount, and when we got in the field, there was additional that needed to be removed, so we just asked them to add it.
Any other discussion?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Okay, motion proper second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, motion passes. Item four, consideration of agreement, City of Franklin contract number 2012-0009 between the City of Franklin and Boyle Investment Company for the construction of the 5 Mile Crossing and Berry Farm Crossing roadway infrastructure.
This is an agreement we've been working with the Berry Farms development concerning the widening of I-65 and the Goose Creek Bypass interchange improvements. If you'll recall, the Old Paintsville Road has to be cul-de-sac'd because it's within too close to the interchange. So to do that, then the state has to provide another access route. And part of that will be through the Berry Farms project, which they were already committed to build as part of their project. So we worked out an agreement where they will go ahead and build that portion within their project. And we've got stipulations of when it has to be completed, et cetera, which is within 12 months of the notice to proceed for the TDOT construction, because they have to be able to have that access there where they can complete their project, the interchange project. So this is an agreement that we've been working on for a while. We've got it worked out, we think. It is recommended for approval with the condition that the final wording of our final language be approved by the city administrator, city engineer, and city attorney, because there is possibility of some minor corrections. So but we think we have it set up for now.
And the one thing that I would add is that for the impacted property owners, they will always have access to Goose Creek Bypass through Old Paintsville Road, or this new routing that the developer will be responsible for constructing, that they won't cut access off until the new roadway is constructed.
I move
it's
for
not
going to
cost us anything.
Second.
Okay. Motion proper second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, motion passes. Item five, consideration of amendment number one to the professional service agreement, City of Franklin contract number 2010-0057 with Kimley Horn and Associate for the Cool Springs area signal improvement and Highway 96 survey for the amount not to exceed $9,800.
Back in 2010, we entered into an agreement with Kimberly Horn for some work for three intersections in the Cool Springs area. We have completed one, and now we're looking at trying to get the Mallory Lane, Mallory Station Road, South Springs Drive intersection out to bid to do the work, try to have it completed before the holiday season coming up in the fall. So, but to do that, we need to have some changes made and updates to the plans and to the work that Kimberly Horn has already done. And we asked for this amendment to their contract to allow to have that work done. We are asking to just go before the board at the next meeting for approval, where we can get it done before the holiday season. That's the reason we're pushing.
Where is the money coming from?
It is it's budgeted under the TOC capital budget under machinery and equipment, less than $25,000. It is a budgeted item, or it will come out of a budgeted item. I'll rephrase that.
This has been out there since 2010, right? So we're trying to close this out.
Well, they started the work in 2010 and did some work. Now we've got to get it updated, et cetera.
Is that why
get the plans, get
expired?
The plans ready for bidding.
Okay.
So that's what we're trying to do.
Did we have them in the beginning and they just expired, or did we?
There's just been some changes to some of the signal equipment, and we sat down with Streetroy prior to bidding, and they caught some things that they wanted to add to the contract. So prior to bidding, just our last QA, QC, looking at it, we decided that we needed to just update the plans.
Okay.
And one thing I would clarify in the financial impact, we may be pulling these dollars from this machinery and equipment, but we need to transfer them into the appropriate line item for professional services contract.
Okay.
So we may be identifying the funding from there, but we got to shift it into the proper line item to pay for professional services.
Does that need to be put back?
You don't need to worry about that. That's just something for us so that we spend it out of the right line item.
Right.
We're reallocating dollars within that budget to the appropriate line item. So
that's
we
fine.
Won't need to I think the call that we're making is that it's better to shift that money from that area to cover this services contract.
I move.
Second.
Okay, motion proper second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, motion passes. Item six, consideration of change order number one, City of Franklin contract number 2012-0110 to the construction contract for the Hillsborough Road Improvement Project, Highway 96 West to Independence Square with Civil Constructors, for the increase of $184,993.74.
This is for mainly two things, and one is being unsuitable subgrade. Once we started doing the storm drainage, then we're talking about going out and using the bar excavation line item to pull in to get the cost for what's going to be needed to come back for backfill for the storm drain. And then also the conduit for the Middle Tennessee Electric up to the commercial buildings has to be encased in concrete. The plans did not show that, and so we have to go back and add that cost to the project. That's what this comes out being. There is no time extension involved with this work. And what we're choosing to do is come forward with this change order versus taking it out of the contingency, because it is such a large amount of money that we felt it's just going to do a change order, take care of it. We still have some contingency funds.
Think there'll be other things?
Yes. There's always going to be other things when you're rebuilding a road that's been there a long time.
Change order number one.
It is one big job.
Yeah.
I mean, every time I go out there, I'm just...
Yeah. A lot of rock.
Actually, less the hill,
yeah.
Where our service center is, yeah. There's less rock there, and I thought it was,
well,
was quite a bit of dirt.
A lot of area being moved.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What are they going to do with the pile of rocks that's over there on the right?
Probably use it for when we do the, we've got a retaining wall there in the low area where the river comes around that has to be done. I'm sure they're looking at thinking of using it for backfill for that area there.
Mm-hmm.
That's the reason to have it over in that area.
I hope all that's being filmed.
Yeah.
I hope we got a record of all that.
We will give you a camera for when you're on the bulldozer and you can do some film.
I'm just waiting for them to hit something historic and some artifacts or something.
Oh, shoot.
Not going to happen.
We don't need more of that.
You don't, a skeleton or a bone?
No.
Just don't tell anybody if you find it.
Do not find a cannonball. All right. Any other discussion?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Okay, motion proper. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, motion passes. Item seven, discussion of the Franklin Municipal Code, Title 15, Chapter 1, Section 15-128, concerning the prohibition of parking in bicycle lanes.
If you recall, at the June 25th BOMA work session, a resident from McKay's Mill came and requested that that there be a parking be allowed on Turning Wheel Lane in the bike lanes, as has been done in other sections of McKay's Mill. Staff is recommending against this. There are several options listed for you to consider. I hope you've read those. Like I said, staff is recommending against it. And when you allow parking in the bike lane, the efficiency or the use of the bike lane is no longer there, and it does create safety issues for bikers. So anyway, the reason I will explain, there was question of the comment or the phrase in the ordinance in 2004 when they did do the allowing the parking. And the phrase that was being questioned, that nobody knew what it meant, or at least they claimed they did not know what it meant. It said, future sections of McKay's Mill subdivision shall properly address vehicular parking and bicycle lanes so that both can be accommodated simultaneously without obstructing bicycle lanes. That phrase is in there because at the time, the other areas where bike lanes were going to go, such as Turning Wheel Lane, their development was not approved. There were development plans had not been submitted and approved, et cetera. So the phrase is put in there to try to force the design of the development such that there's adequate parking that does not interfere with the bike lanes. So that's the reason that phrase is in there. It was put in there purposely. In fact, I'm the one that put it in there. But it's there for a reason, and that was to try to get the design of the development such that we could have adequate parking for the residents and have the bike lanes, as everybody's wanting to have bicycle facilities, et cetera. So anyway, just wanted to explain that.
So we don't have that now.
Well, there's adequate parking. They just don't like where the parking is, evidently. That's my understanding of the situation. I'll put it that way.
I'm of the mindset that I would, at this juncture, would like a formal request, too, from the HOA. I would want to.
I just think this should be decided by the people that live out there. Yeah. Lord, I don't know anything about it.
No, well, we had the one resident bring this forward. I think she's out of town until September or something like that. So I don't know what the expectation is in terms of how we follow up on it, or if you want us to work back through her or through the HOA or what.
But the other, the other issue is
this. Some guidance. We don't want to ignore it, but we have.
But it affects more than just the residents there, because it is bike lanes that are used or can be used by all the residents of the city. So, and keep in mind also, this is just up the hill from our park. So anyway, we're bringing it as a discussion here because we need to get direction somewhat of how you want us to proceed forward with it. If you want us to have contact back with the HOA to see if you can get a formal request from the HOA. At least that's, I think, something that needs to be done before you don't do something based on one person, I'm saying. And then we go forward. But anyway.
You make a good point. This is bigger than the HOA.
It is bigger than just that area.
Because of the access to the park, public using that bike lane is just not HOA. So we, as an elected body, will have a major say in that, not just the HOA. So,
but it probably needs to be a request from the HOA.
Minimum needs
before you even go beyond.
Minimum needs to be a request from the HOA, and then we need to, as you've explained, address it further as far as what implications it has from a safety standpoint, and the fact that if we're going to build bike lanes, that's the intent of the bike lane, is for bicycles, not for parking, and there should have been adequate accommodations made for parking. And if I've heard you correctly, the parking is adequate. It's just not where somebody wants
it
to
be. That's
convenient. It's not
from
house.
I do want to address one other issue. There was an issue brought up about the fact of needing to have a handicap parking spot. I know Clyde will remember this, but we have uniformly recommended not to have handicapped parking spots designated when it is a parallel parking situation. What that does, it puts your handicapped driver opening their door into the lane of traffic, and if you'll recall, all our handicapped spots are wider where they have room to do the maneuvering in and out for the handicapped person, the driver. Well, if you open into the travel lane, then you're creating a safety issue for them, because they typically take more space to be able to get in and out of their vehicle than a
don't they have a ability to enter from the backs of their houses?
That's where the parking is, I understand. I really haven't looked at it that close, but I understand the parking is enough parking, but they have to go all the way around the building because of the way the design of the buildings are, or something. That's my understanding.
And you may have to come to the front entrance around the building. There's some inconvenience there, I think, as well. So, problems there.
Okay, next steps. So,
well, the motion could be to prohibit parking in the bike lanes. So
you could do that. You could direct us to go back through the HOA and seek a request from the HOA.
I would say that. I'm not going to vote for anything.
Right now, you don't have to do anything as far as no parking in bike lanes, because it is prohibited when you have a bike lane.
But we need to get back.
I would like to see some more conversation with the HOA.
Like I said, we can have the start trying to get the input from HOA, see if there's more than just the one or two people that are wanting to pursue this. We'd do that. and we'll come back.
All right.
Thank you.
Keep it on.
All right, so no action on that?
Now, it may not be the next meeting, but we'll keep.
That's fine.
That might get that resident back.
It really doesn't, probably doesn't need to be on the next meeting, doesn't need to be until the September meeting anyway.
Yeah, she's out there, that's right.
All right, no action on that, that was a discussion item. Item eight, consideration of change order number two, City of Franklin contract number 2011-0151 for the Franklin TOC Phase Three Field Hardware Project with Stan's Electric Company for an increase of $24,259.
Excuse me, this is to add some additional fiber splicing due to the Matt Catcher project and also some changes that were requested by the city's IT department. There also, there is a time delay or additional 203 days for the project, and that's because, again, of the Matt Catcher creating the situation of not being able to be completed in the contracted time. This is a federally funded project, 80-20, so the change order would be for $24,259. The city's portion of that would be $4,851.80. We do have to get approval, concurrent approval from TDOT for this change order. I don't know that we've gotten anything in writing yet from that. I think they're probably waiting on us.
They're waiting on us, we have to do it first.
This will be, approval is contingent upon getting approval from TDOT. The additional funds, again, are out of the same Traffic Operations Center capital budget, machinery and equipment, under $25,000. It would be the $4,851.80. And again, as Mr. Stuckey said, that would be something that has to be transferred through the thing, but that would be where the funds would come from. The city's portion of the funds.
You need a motion.
We need to move this on so that TDOT can move on.
And I would add that the project's 100% complete right now. We're just working on the final paperwork for the final change order. So that'll be coming here shortly.
Move for approval.
Second.
All right, motion proper second, all in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes.
Now, Eric, would you put this on the consent agenda then for the regular, for the special call board meeting?
Yeah, this would be on the July 23rd.
All these items are.
Yeah.
Okay.
Except for the discussion on.
Yeah, okay. All right, we're down to item nine, 10, 11, which will be our street and water and.
Before you get actually that, if you don't mind.
You got some other discussion, other business?
Just a quick CIP project status.
Okay.
I have six of the nine lists submitted to me. We are lacking three.
No.
Lacking three, what?
Priority listing.
No.
The top 10 priority, three aldermen have not turned in their list.
I know, I was late last time, but I'm first.
May I be excused?
Nobody at this table, okay, but.
Oh, there is, yeah.
You don't have to call us out like that. They don't have to call us out like that.
I'm not trying to, and I've talked to one of the others already today, and I think Mr. Stuckey will probably be emailing you, but anyway, I just wanted to let you know, that's, soon as we get those in, and I've already got all the others already put in the spreadsheet, so we'll be hoping to bring that back to you. Have you said anything about special meeting?
Because we really want to, yeah. This is important.
Wait a minute, if anybody hadn't turned it in, I think they ought to forfeit their number one.
And make it your number one.
Ain't no way. Because I'm betting my number one ain't your number one.
So what kind of timeframe, realizing that my colleagues will do the right thing soon?
As soon as possible, we're going to try to give an update at the January, or January.
Wow.
Jeez, July 23rd. No, I hope not. July 23rd, work session, we're just going to kind of give an update of where, that we've got the priorities, looking at where we may go next in terms of update of the financial model, because we now finished the fiscal year and are looking to get at least the unaudited numbers that we can then update the model and show our capacity.
Yeah.
And then we have staff kind of working on a list to consider as well, kind of our input.
Depending on if, If I can get the other three, even as late as the Friday before that meeting, I can hand out the spreadsheet showing what the priorities from the board would be. But it just depends on when we get there. It won't take long once we get to all of them.
So noted.
Not that this is a meeting item, but if you'll sit down with me at 1:00 tomorrow, you'll have mine. My questions have been whether or not we're still eligible, whether there's an 80-20 federal grant on Lewisburg Highway, phase one, phase two, whether there's a federal grant 80-20 on McHatcher. And those then become leveraged dollars for me that when I prioritize, I understand that I'm getting $100 million worth of project for $20 million worth of investment.
You're talking about the listing that we gave you concerning what the MPO was looking at.
Is in the MPO process.
To answer your question, we cannot tell you a definite answer right now because that approval from the MPO for those projects is not due until the end of September. So it'd be the first of the year, first of their fiscal year.
But we do have some speculation.
But if they approve it, it would be, if they approve it as being recommended by the MPO staff, et cetera, there is the 80-20. It would be eligible for the 80-20 match.
Well, it's that, and that's important wording. It's eligible for the 80-20 match. Mm-hmm. It's still got to get funded. It's still got to go through the process of getting funded through TDOT. So there's no guarantee that you putting it on the list gets it funded at 80-20, but they are eligible projects to get that kind of support.
But if it's not funded through the 80-20, then it comes off. It's irrelevant that it's on my list.
Because yes.
It's only on my list if it's 80-20.
Okay, right.
As a leverage. Got any other?
Do you want to touch on any specific project?
Progress? Touch.
Okay, we're back on what, item 9?
I would touch on a few projects. I think I said this last meeting, but 3rd Avenue North Extension, we're right now in the process of processing a time extension for the project. We ran into some delays with the overhead electric, so we're still trying to get that project completed by December of this year, but just want to highlight that may be coming forward here shortly. And then also, the utilities have been relocating at McEwen Drive and Wilson Pike intersection. I believe AT&T is almost or already out of the way. We've gone ahead and issued the notice to proceed on that project, so we're excited about that project kicking off, and they're starting to deliver materials to the site, and you should see work out there shortly. And then finally, the access roadway to the new public works facility. The work's been done for a while. We're just trying to wait on weather to cooperate with us to get the paving done and then the signal work done, but they're making great progress out there, and we're looking forward to wrapping that project up here
this
in the near future.
Which road?
This is the public works access roadway.
Flasco property.
Oh,
when they get
84.
To public, yeah.
Okay.
So those are the highlights of this month. If there's any specific questions on projects,
and,
I'm happy
and
to.
And the road between Beasley and?
It's, we're working on right-of-way acquisition right now. We have one property remaining before we finalize the plans. However, what I would say that we've been making a lot of progress on is Atmos Gas has already relocated all of their facilities. We're right now getting estimates from AT&T and Middle Tennessee Electric to move their facilities, and as soon as we get those, we're going to be bringing contracts forward for them, and we're waiting on them, and we're working with them to be able to finalize those plans. And once that's finalized, you'll see the project move really quickly. But the problem is, if we go ahead and bid the project, you'll mobilize a contractor that'll just sit and wait for the utilities to get out of the way. So it's important that we work those details out now.
It's such a small area. I don't know what's taking them so long.
There's a lot of overhead utilities that are right in the way that are servicing all those buildings there, and there's a lot of contracts that we have to get together, and they're working on it now. And as soon as we can bring those forward, they'll come forward.
Paul mentioned the public works facility. We've completed the demo within the two buildings out there, and actual construction work is starting now.
Okay.
So that project is truly underway, and we hope the road will get paved if it ever stops raining long enough to pave the road. But we're making good progress, and that project is moving along now.
You anticipate being in the new public works
I would
for
hope
Christmas?
A year from now we have folks out there working.
Okay, all right.
And I've actually received some a lot of calls about Columbia Avenue and Southeast Parkway, so I'd just throw that out there.
The signal there.
We are finalized with the design of it. There's a little bit of right-of-way that's necessary with the project, so we're in the process of getting that right-of-way, but we're still shooting to try to bid that project out October, November, December timeframe, so that we're starting first of the year.
So are we taking a signal out?
We're installing a signal at that Chick-fil-A intersection. It's actually the best way to landmark it.
Weren't there some plans at some point in time to take the one out next to the Kroger gas pumps?
At some point, the access is to come out. They're not a signal. Oh.
The signal would stay, but there's an access.
Yeah. The signal is at the main entrance into the whatever that shopping center is called.
Target and Kroger.
There is an access right next to the fueling station there that wants all the connection between that
and
subdivision.
That's not signalized, right?
Why would that come out?
For traffic control. Better traffic control if we take it out.
Some people want to come out.
They can come out.
There's an interconnection set up to be done between the shopping center area, actually two, and this
Chick-fil-A.
Where that Chick-fil-A in that development. And once that's done, then that access point would come out.
Okay.
Because it'd be an interconnection, and that interconnection would allow people to get to either one of the signals.
Right.
Okay.
Is Carlisle Lane going good? I haven't heard anything.
Carlisle Lane's going great. You've seen them on one side of the road for a long period of time, but they've been relocating a lot of utilities. Those are all completed now. They've relocated a water line, AT&T line, so you should see that project moving really fast at this point.
We're talking about Carlisle.
Carlisle Lane.
Why is the sidewalk so wide? It's a what? It's a
pedestrian bicycle path.
Multi-use, it's not just pedestrian, but it's
is this something bikes. New?
When Matt Catcher,
everybody wants to know why the sidewalk's so wide.
When Matt Catcher gets constructed, they're going to be extending the multi-use path associated with Matt Catcher extension down 96 to tie into this. So you'll have a wonderful multi-use trail that'll wrap all the way around the new extension.
So you can walk on it, ride a bike on it.
So we plan it for the future.
It's not just a sidewalk.
So we don't have
and
to.
Train mm-hmm. for mountain climbing on.
That's right. That'd be a good suggestion.
All right, any other items on streets?
Actually, you can walk sideways more.
It's looking like it's ahead of schedule. I don't have an exact date to give you, but they've got the curb poured out there, and we're getting ready to do the pervious parking area and put down the double bituminous surface. So as of now, it's ahead of schedule, but I don't have an exact date to give you.
Wow, that's good news. Any other discussion on street project? Next, water management, item 10. Water management.
If there's any questions, as Mark's coming up.
There'll be a public meeting for the 11th Avenue Improvements Project. We're still working on finalizing that date, but we'll email that out through Mr. Stuckey to the board so that you'll be aware of that public meeting for the roadway sidewalk improvements that we discussed last time, as well as the infrastructure that'll be done. That's probably the only thing I would highlight.
All right, let me just bring this up right here. We're talking about 11th Avenue and the sidewalks and all. I brought this up before, and nobody liked my suggestion about whenever we pave a street, whenever we touch a street, that we just add sidewalks. I'm not going to let that go because I know it's expensive, but we've got somebody to do sidewalks.
We're completing the sidewalk in that area as part of that project.
Yeah, I know, but then we talked about Petway, and we talked about some other places that when you're doing street work anyway, when you're repaving the street.
When we do street improvements such that we do drainage and curb and gutter, or it has curb and gutter or curbs or whatever, and adequate drainage, then we can easily look at adding sidewalks. Petway is a roadside ditch section, and we to do sidewalks, we would need to go and do curb and gutter, drainage facilities, etc., to be able to do the sidewalks correct. It's the same situation we're running into on Franklin Road. So,
will you consider that when you do curb and gutter and when you do
when we do curb and gutter, we
always do
when
sidewalks.
We do curb and gutter. If we're going to improve a road and do curb and gutter, we design it for having sidewalks.
Because I have people tell me every day we need sidewalks all over this town. Mm-hmm. And I don't know what to tell them except takes money, and we don't have the money.
That's the main issue.
I think that's very appropriate to tell them, Margaret, that it's a funding issue, and you know.
We have provided some funding where we didn't before for some sidewalk work, but it only goes so far. So that's part of what we look at and setting those priorities when we do that work.
Okay. Now we'll move on to water of the streets. Okay, I think mine is the battle project. That's under the next one. Anything on no, item 10? If not, we'll go to item 11, stormwater project. The battle project.
Battle Avenue.
We've got the survey results, and we're still working on scheduling. We're still trying to process it all. I forget the exact number of responses that we got from the residents out there. But the plan is to schedule a public meeting with the residents out there, present the information to them, and then bring it back to the a work session to present the final report. So it's still a work in progress. I think we had talked about
work session or CIC.
Which did
we want to?
What's that?
Whether we're bringing back the full report on battle, if you want it here, or
we were talking about doing a work session since the whole board is involved.
Okay,
that's what we were talking about.
That's probably right.
We're going to have a neighbor meeting.
Yes,
we're working on setting up.
For 11th.
Yes.
That's what we're still working on.
Come back to the full work session, the full board.
So we got two neighborhood meetings. We have the 11th Avenue mm-hmm. and we have battle.
That's right. Correct.
Should be coming up in.
And as soon as we can set dates, we'll email it out to the board and we'll advertise in the paper and reach out to all the residents.
Okay. Any other item of discussion?
Can I give you an item on scheduling, and we'll follow up a little mm-hmm. more detail with the rest of the board. We'd like to look at having the next CIC meeting a couple days earlier on August 6th. Okay. That's the Tuesday, as opposed to the Thursday, August 8th. We've got Mr. Parker out of town, so we'd like to have him here. We also are gearing up to have a presentation at that meeting, kind of in conjunction with that meeting, maybe do our normal CIC business at 4, and then tag on to that a presentation on biosolids, one of the issues we've been working on in the sewer side of things.
You mean $60 million project?
Yeah.
No longer 60.
We hope less than that now. We've been working on bringing that number down. So we'd like to have some time to discuss that then while we have you. We'll get with the rest of the board to see if we can get everybody here for that, maybe you know at 5 o'clock or something like that.
On August 6th, you said?
On the 6th.
Mm-hmm.
Would that be okay with?
That would be with me.
Okay.
It's a Tuesday, and it's a non.
Mr. Stuckey doesn't want me to be gone when we talk about biosolids.
I think a biosolid.
I just see you, David. I think biosolids.
It would be an excellent presentation.
We'll have that in a minute. So,
so the 6th.
Tuesday.
What time?
The 6th at 4 o'clock for CIC, right? 4 o'clock for CIC. And then 5 o'clock, if we can get everybody here, do biosolid discussion, presentation, get you something to think about on that one.
Okay. Yeah, look at CIC and make sure that we're not squeezing something that we don't need to squeeze. But
yeah. That's the reason we're keeping it an hour.
I think the three of us probably could make an earlier than 4 meeting on CIC if you need it.
At the present time, we don't see that there's going to be very many items on CIC, or what we would need to talk about CIC, especially since we probably will not be talking about the bike lane stuff then. Mm-hmm. So, is that it for that?
Have we closed down Jackson Lake? I mean, the last
just to
the money we approved.
Yeah. We're in a lawsuit situation. So we do not need to be discussing Jackson Lake in a public meeting. So we will probably be discussing Jackson Lake with you some at the next executive session.
All right.
Okay. You had any other comments?
I got one thing back up to the water projects, but this is actually a sewer project that the project's been done for a while. We have we had 16 condemnation lawsuits on the Five Mile Creek sewer that's the sewer that goes out toward Berry Farms. We have now settled 15 of those outstanding. We had more than that, but we had 16 outstanding. We only have one left to settle, so just to give you that update. Mr. Stuckey is going to be giving you more information concerning that once I get it to him. So, but I just wanted to kind of mention that today, that we've gotten 15 of the 16 settled.
So noted for the minutes. Any other additional comments for the CIC? Otherwise, I would entertain an adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
Okay, our motion. All in favor?
Aye.
We are adjourned.